when we went to China, he woke me up at 3 o'clock in the morning. And he said, Melissa, it's time to go. And I said, what? It's 3 in the morning. He said, yeah, we have to go get on our flight. I said, no. And he goes, come on, get up. And he leaves the room. And I go, I love you, you stupid goldfish. One look at you. My dearest Melissa and Shori, I'm writing this on the day of our wedding with tears in my eyes, butterflies in my stomach, and so much joy that I could cry. I know that you know that I love you, but I'll tell you that I love you every day by word, every hour by action, every minute by thought, and every second through the glorification of Christ. Oh, I can't believe it's
true. I get to love. I've always been afraid of losing Melissa, but I couldn't imagine losing her to a better guy. You see, Melissa is a rare gem. She can make anybody her friend, whether they want it or not, because she has so much love to give and knows who needs it without them having to say anything. So when it came to finding someone she would spend the rest of her life with, I knew she needed someone that would giggle when she called them a stupid goldfish. I get to love.
For the past 11 months and 19 days, I have been committed to you. I have seen you and watched you grow. I have seen you persevere through overwhelming odds and conquer your fears and control your passions. I am committed to not only loving you, who you are today, but to always choosing to love you. And I promise to forsake everyone except for you, and to be committed to a lifelong pursuit of you. Until forever, Timothy Dean Robert Shori. I get to love you. I have seen you, Melissa. I know you. I know your heart for helping people, even if they don't deserve it. I have seen and understand your desire to grow as a family in a righteous direction of the Lord. I know you deeply, and I will cherish you forever. None of the bad will ever be too bad. None of the sickness will ever scare me away. None of the pain we may cause each other will cause me to leave you. None of the joy will cause me to forget who you truly are. I see you. I know you. I love you as you are now. The craziest part to me is that you also know me. You truly deeply know me as I know you. You know my faults, of which there are many. You know that I'm a sinner, a broken man. You know me, and you love me so deeply that I have every confidence that we will be committed to one another forever. I will strive to be your balance and temper you through our sanctification that is the fire of life, that will bring us closer to God and the unimaginable joy. I am willing to spend the rest of forever loving you and cherishing you to find out exactly who you are. I get to love you. P.S. I love you, you stupid goldfish.
It's with great joy that I introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Tim Shori. You may kiss your bride.
Melissa called me one night and told me about having a heart attack at Ultimate Frisbee. And this guy named Tim helping her out. And then they were going out to dinner, but just as friends. And I rolled my eyes over the phone because I didn't believe that. But fast forward 2 years later, I'll never forget being in a stairwell at work, listening to a voicemail from Tim, saying he had just had the most terrifying conversation of his life. And I knew that meant that he had asked Dale to marry her, and I teared up.
I've never felt less of a third wheel hanging out with a couple than with Tim and Mel. I mean, they just make you feel wanted and loved and not a burden whenever they hang out with you. So it's really special. I just want to say cheers to Tim and Mel, and may God bless them on whatever adventure they go on. Damn.